The first question, as I recall, was about why we had Iranian embassies in our countries. Well, we don't have an embassy in the United States. We have an interest section that is administered by Pakistan. Beyond me. You know, Iran has been at war with the United States for 31 years. They have continuously mounted attacks against our military and civilians, killed thousands, if you include 9/11, which they were involved in. And to this day are working with terror proxies and enemies of the United States and coalition allies like Canada in Iraq and Afghanistan, where Iran is arming, training, and providing with weapons the Iraqi terrorist organizations as well as the Taliban. So we've got to realize this is a country that's at war with us. Whether we're at war yet with them, that's the question, but they're at war with us. Okay. The penetration into the United States and our media, for instance, but other organizations as well. It's very sophisticated. It's very broad based. They're very good at mounting influence operations. They have personalities. They have individuals who are very, very good at this. And unfortunately, they are deep inside of our own government. Inside, they're providing briefings to the CIA. They are providing briefings to policymakers at the highest levels in the United States. When I mentioned that Iran lobby, I didn't make up that term. That term comes straight out of the Iranian press, where they wrote in their own media, which is all government controlled, that there is an Iran lobby in America. They wrote that in transcribed into Farsi language. That was their description of the influence operations in America. I don't know if the CIA read it or not, but I did. Yes, the nuclear strike in Syria, not nuclear strike, but the strike against the Syrian nuclear facility being built by North Korea. Yes, there is an axis of evil, an axis of terror, if you will, and it involves Iran, Syria, North Korea, and of course the terrorist organizations, Al-Qaeda, Hamas, Hezbollah. That facility being built in Syria that was struck by the Israelis in September 2007 was indeed a nuclear facility built along, as you just said, the floor plans of a known North Korean nuclear facility just like it. The North Koreans have been very much involved in helping Iran, for instance, to build the tunnels under the mountains, the bunkers in which it is hiding its WMD programs. It is also involved in helping, obviously, Syria. Saddam Hussein did have weapons of mass destruction. Because for one thing, he used chemical weapons against his own people at one point in Halabja in 1987-88. But he also had the biological weapons, and he also had elements of a nuclear program to be reconstituted the moment he was able to do that. Those elements, a lot of them, were trucked out and flown out of Iraq just before the American invasion in 2003. The Russian Spetsnaz helped to take some of those elements out of Iraq, and some of those elements went to Syria. That's where they began their nuclear program. Apparently what is happening is that North Korea is providing some of the expertise, Iran is funding it. It's the money from Iran that funds it. The North Koreans provide their expertise and their know-how and their construction abilities. And Syria now has, for the first time, a nuclear weapons program, or incipient or intended program.
Great. So I think we're going to take it offline, and you can speak to Claire privately. It's time to eat.
Oh, come on!
Thank you very much.